who hangs out all the time at the club is Phil Ochs, a great folk singer. Phil, listen, you've been writing and performing for several years, and you've been at the club maybe 55 times, but you've never performed there. Why?
Well, because you never asked me to perform when I needed the break.
When you need the bread?
You know, when I needed the break and the exposure, you know. It was a commercial club then, and I wasn't commercial.
And you're now...
Now
what?
I'm commercial by default.
By default?
Because I'm still alive and performing after all these years.
How does that make you all of a sudden commercial?
Well, because most folk singers are gone someplace else.
You started to say most fink.
No, well, that was a force of habit.
Okay, go ahead.
And most folk singers have, most finks have disappeared.
All folk singers.
Yeah, and they've joined rock and roll groups, you know, and so I'm still here.
That's true.
And I haven't changed over the years. I'm just as dull as ever, so.
Oh, come on. Listen, no. I just recently I was on the coast, right, Phil? We were both there together, and you were doing a great promotion with posters all over the place. You even enlisted me to paste them all over Malibu. What
right.
was that all about? Why don't you tell everybody? Cause
oh, well, I got involved with the politics of the absurd in California, which is it was a theater demonstration in which we declared the war over in Vietnam and celebrated the end of the war. On June 23rd in Los Angeles, we celebrated the end of the war, and we're going to probably do that in New York sometime soon also, just as a theater piece. And we have a poster which says that, a picture of the sailor kissing the girl from Times Square, VE Day.
It's one of your protest ideas. I mean, you're
yeah,
basically...
Yeah.
Are you known as a protest folk singer?
Yeah, I am.
You know, I know, that's great.
Which is a dirty lie. I've never protested.
I think it's great. You write always about current things, I notice. For instance, did anything happen yesterday that you wrote about today?
Well, let's see. I wrote about, the ballad of Louise Day Hicks. And I finished late last night.
Late last night, right?
And,
that's great. Listen, what are you going to sing tonight? Because there's so many great songs you have.
Well, I've got a couple. I'll do one oldie but goodie from the old days, which is called My Dropped Flap Pick.
Your and, Dropped Flap Pick, that's one.
Otherwise
right?
known as There But For Fortune.
Yeah.
And then the other one will be a song I wrote after I saw you in California, a song... about the a song written after a demonstration, which it's a song which declares the war over. It's a new kind of song. It's not a protest song. It's a different kind.
Last thing about
it's
it.
A
before
protest
you
song.
Sing the songs, I noticed lately you've been singing with a lot of orchestration. You've really got, you know, no longer is it simple folk singers with just a guitar. Are you happy with the way your latest album turned out?
Yeah, well, for the album only, not for stage, but for the album we orchestrated every song, and sometimes symphony.
You get along fine without it. Why all of a sudden?
I wanted to extend my musical boundaries.
And you think this does it?
Yeah, I think the lyrics are.
What about the folk singers who were turning rock, like the Mamas and Papas and the Lovin' Spoonfuls?
No, you can turn any way you want. I thought I was much more interested in counterpoint, countermelody, and you know, orchestral textural sounds rather than just putting a rock band in the back of me.
Well, you're one of my favorite. Folk sing. I gotta tell you, listen, there's no question about it. So let's sing.
Thank you.
Okay.
You're one of my favorite club owners.
Okay, right?